फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट राइट नाउ टेल मी एनीवन थीटा लाइज इन विच क्वाड्रेंट बेटा राइट थीटा लाइज इन विच क्वाड्रेंट एनीवन थीटा लाइज इन विच क्वाड्रेंट राइट हम लोग ही सेइंग दैट Q3 रॉन्ग आंसर बेटा एनीवन अंडरस्टूड द क्वेश्चन बेटा राइट शशांक वेरी गुड थीटा लाइज इन फोर्थ क्वाड्रेंट इज इट राइट बेटा बिकॉज सर हाउ यू आर सेइंग इन Q4 फोर्थ क्वाड्रेंट बिकॉज यह I don't know the value of t, but t lies in between 0 and 1. T lies in between 0 and 1 means it is positive. Is it right, beta? So the values between 0 and 1 are positive values. That means here cos theta is positive. Cos theta is given as positive. So cos theta is positive in which quadrants? In first and fourth. Already in the question they said that theta does not lie in Q1. That means theta lies in which quadrant, beta? Theta lies in which quadrant? Right, fourth quadrant. Okay. Now we can find what we have to find in the question. We have to find number A. First one is sine theta. Okay. All right. For this, draw the graph. Draw the diagram. All right. So here, what is given? Cos theta. Cos theta means adjacent by hypotenuse. By definition, is it right, beta? To find the side, I explain one method. Okay, to find the side, we have to subtract from the hypotenuse. Is it right, beta? This is easy method. I will denote like this. Right? To find the side, we have to subtract from hypotenuse after squaring. That means we get 1 minus t square for the square root. Is it right, beta? So this is the side. I am subtracting from hypotenuse after doing square. 1 square means 1. T square means T square. 1 minus T square, for that we have to draw right square root. Now from this diagram, sine theta is first observe beta. Here theta lies in fourth quadrant. In fourth sine is negative. First we have to write minus. After that we have to observe the graph. Observe the diagram. From this, what is sine beta? Sine theta definition. Opposite by hypotenuse. From this we get root over 1 minus T square. Okay, clear? Next, we have one more question in this. Right, B, tan theta. Now tell me, here first we have to write theta is in Q4, means negative. Is it right, beta? In fourth quadrant, tan is also negative. From the diagram, we can say that tan means opposite by hypotenuse. So these are the values. This is important question, beta. Already we got this problem in 2 marks. 1 minute, beta. Video is blurred. Now it is okay, beta. Video and audio. Vagdevi. Vagdevi, any doubt? Okay. So this is right. In first beta, fourth, second one, beta. This is important. Can you write this notes, beta? Can I give the question this one? If you want to write the answer, write down the question, beta. Write down question in fourth, second one. Write down, beta. This is an important one. All of you write down this question. If cos theta equals to t in brackets 0 less than t less than 1 and theta does not lie and theta does not lie Theta does not lie in the first quadrant. In the first quadrant, comma, find the value of find the values of A sin theta, B tan theta. I think first one is completed. Is it right, beta? In fourth one, first one is completed. I think cos theta, cot theta. In that we are finding cos theta and cot theta. Fourth one, first one. In fourth, first problem. So for this, write down the solution. Write down, beta. Given. Write down solution for this. Given. Cos theta equals to t. Cos theta equals to t. Where 0 less than t less than 1. That is t is positive. Okay, na beta? And one more condition is given in the question. And theta does not lies in. Lies in, simply we can write Q1 beta. That means first quadrant. That implies T is positive means cos is positive. Okay, na? So it implies theta lies in fourth quadrant. Is it right, beta? Q4. Or we can say fourth quadrant. Anyone? I will write Q4. Now, take directly now A and B. Take this diagram, beta. From the diagram only we are writing the values. But here we have to observe whether it is positive or negative. It depends on the quadrant in which theta lies. Is it right, beta? Because this is important one. Next, I think third one is also important. I think all of you completed that problem, beta. Third one. Next, I will give one question in the second bit, beta. I will ask one problem, whether we have completed that problem or not, we'll check. Okay, completed, beta. After final write down, therefore, sin theta equal, write these values, beta, minus root of 1 minus t square and tan theta equal minus of root over 1 minus t square by t. Okay? Third bit, second question. I will explain, beta. Okay, we'll discuss all the problems today. So third bit, second question, third problem. Okay, beta. All right. One minute. Okay, completed, beta, this one. Next, so once see this question, beta. In second bit, so this is also important. In second bit, second one, in this second, third question. Completed, all of you? Third one, in second bit, second. Completed, beta, once see the question. If alpha beta are complementary angles such that is the question, beta, that is our question. Completed. Or I will write the question on the board, beta. Right. I will explain because that is also important one. Write on this question in second bit. second bit, second one, in second, third one. If alpha comma beta are complementary angles, complementary angles such that B sin alpha equals to A comma, then find the value of find the value of then find the value of sin alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sin beta. So this is our question, beta. Here the given is alpha beta are complementary angles such that B sin alpha equals to A. Then find the value of sin alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sin beta. Okay beta, all right. First listen carefully. Yeah, so the given is B sin alpha equals A. I will write the solution beta. First say on the board, right? Solution given. What is given here? Alpha beta are complementary angles. Okay, alpha beta are complementary angles, right? So that implies here we get one condition. When we say two angles are complementary, beta, I think already I given the formula for this. Is it right? Alpha plus beta equals to 90 degrees. Is it right, beta? I am calling this as equation one. And one more condition is given in the question, that is B sin alpha equals to A. Is it right, beta? From this I can write sin alpha equals to A by B. Okay, clear? Right, from this I can write sin alpha equals to A by B. Right. Now, I want to find this value, beta. Sin alpha cos beta, cos alpha sin beta. To find the value of this one, first I want to know what is, right here sin alpha, only sin alpha is given. Now my ambition is to find cos alpha, sin beta and cos beta. Is it right, beta? From this sin alpha, I can easily find cos alpha. Is it right, beta? Right, sin alpha is A by B. I am taking the diagram for alpha angle, beta. Here I am taking alpha. Right, sin is given. Sin means what is the definition, beta? Opposite by hypotenuse. Is it right now? Next, to find the side, to find the another side, to find the remaining side, we have to subtract from hypotenuse. What we are getting, beta? B square minus A square for this square root. From this, I can write cos alpha. Now tell me, what is the value of cos alpha, beta? Here, for alpha and beta, there is no condition. There is no condition means alpha beta lies in the first quadrant. Already I explained in the previous class, beta. Whenever we are not considering about the quadrants, that means the angles are in the first quadrant. So the cos alpha becomes, right? What is the definition for cos, beta? Adjacent by hypotenuse. From this, what we are getting? Root over b square minus a square by b. Okay. Now we have the values of sin alpha and cos alpha. Next, we need the values of sin beta and cos beta. Now from equation one. Now I am taking sin beta value, beta. For example, I am taking sin beta. Right. So this equals the sin. I can write beta by equation one as 90 minus alpha. Is it right, beta? Since how we write this one? Since from equation one. Is it right, beta? From equation one, I am writing the value of beta. Beta can be written as 90 minus alpha. If we observe this, right? First, 90 minus alpha lies in which quadrant, beta? First quadrant. In first quadrant, all are positive. 90s are integers, so ratio will be changed. So means cos alpha. Is it right, beta? Already we know the value of cos alpha, right? So this is sin beta. Finally, we got the value of sin beta. What is the value of sin beta, beta? Root over b square minus a square by b. Okay, clear? So this is sine beta, and now we'll find cos beta, right? And cos beta equals we can write similarly cos beta can be written as 90 minus alpha. From this we get sine alpha. Is it like the beta? Already we know the value of sine alpha. What is sine alpha? A by B. This is the value of cos beta. Now we find the required one. Now consider what we have to find, beta. Take that one. Now sine alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sine beta equals. So substitute in this, we get the required one. Okay, na beta. So sine alpha. What is sine alpha? A by B. Right. Into cos beta is also A by B. Minus cos alpha. Right. Cos alpha is root over B square minus A square by B. This is cos alpha. Into sine beta. Sine beta is also same that one. Root over B square minus A square by B. Right. Do the simplification. Finally, we get A square by B square minus A root will be cancelled. So B square minus A square by B square. Now take the LCM. What is the LCM beta here? B square. So here A square minus into plus B square minus B square minus into minus plus A square. Finally, we are getting the value as 2A square minus B square by B square. Okay, beta. Any doubts? So this is the value of sine alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sine beta. Any doubts, beta? Once say step by step. Once again, I will explain, beta. Here the given is alpha beta. Important one. Okay. Alpha beta are complementary angles. Already we know the definition of complementary angles. That is sum is 90 degrees. Okay. And one more condition is given, that is B sine alpha equals A. From that I can write sine alpha. By using that diagram I can write cos alpha also. Remember, beta, to find the side we have to subtract from the hypotenuse after doing square, right? So from that we can write cos alpha. Next, I want to know the values of sine beta and cos beta. For that I'm writing beta equals to 90 minus alpha from equation 1. Here after easy steps. Okay, now substitute in the given, we get the required condition. Write down, beta. I will change the markers, beta. First complete this. Okay, beta, complete it. Write neatly, beta. I will give time. Remember one point, beta. We have to solve each and every problem in our textbook. Okay. In last, write this one, beta. Therefore. Therefore, sine alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sine beta equals to 2a square minus b square by b square. Okay. राइट ओके रक्षिता इन वाग दे अलाफे कंप्लीटेड बेटा राइट राइट आई विल आस्क वन मोर क्वेश्चन बेटा सो इन सेकंड बिट इन सेकंड बिट third second completed beta first and second are for from all silver tikas we can find the values beta or from the diagram we can find I think in third first and sorry this is third one first and second in second bit in third first and second are completed I think third one third I will give the question beta if A comma B comma C comma D. If A, B, C, D are angles of a cyclic quadrilateral, completed, beta. Cyclic quadrilateral. Then show that. Then prove that. Cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, right. I will explain it now. Cyclic quadrilateral, comma. Write down the question. Then prove that. A. Sine A minus sine C equals to sine D minus sine B. Next B, cos A plus cos B plus cos C plus cos D equals zero. Prachodan. All is our first year students beta Prachodan. Okay, right. Okay, beta clear. So first understood the question what is given here. A, B, C, D are angles of a cyclic quadrilateral. Okay, na beta. Now tell me what is the condition if A, B, C, D are angles of a cyclic quadrilateral? Anyone? Yeah, the condition is here. The given is A, B, C, D are angles of a cyclic quadrilateral. Is it right, beta? Right. The given is A, B, C, D are angles of a cyclic quadrilateral means that is, for example, I am considering a quadrilateral on a cycle. Okay. So this is. We call this as cyclic quadrilateral. Is it right, beta? So this is right. All diagonals are 90 degrees. Anyone? So observe the diagram, beta. Right. So we call this quadrilateral as cyclic because this is inscribed in a circle. Okay, na, beta. Cyclic quadrilateral means if a quadrilateral is inscribed in a circle, then that quadrilateral is called cyclic quadrilateral. Is it right, beta? Inscribed or also extribed. Okay, now for example, I am taking like this. So if you observe, for example, I am calling this quadrilateral as ABCD. Now, if ABCD are angles of a cyclic quadrilateral, means if you add these A plus C, what we are getting, beta? A plus C means we are getting this total angle. So that means this will be how much? 180 degrees. Is it right, beta? A plus C equals 180 degrees. Similarly, B plus D is also 180 degrees. Is it right? So this is the condition given. Okay, now, beta, understood? Whenever we are saying A, B, C, D are angles of a cyclic quadrilateral, then we have to draw the diagram, beta. From the diagram, we can observe what is the condition behind this concept. Right, here the condition is A plus C equals 180 degrees and B plus D equals 180 degrees. From these two conditions, I can find the values. We'll see number A, first one's beta. First lizard, don't write. Number one, first one. Right, I'm considering sin A minus sin C. Okay, beta, sin A minus sin C equals to, we'll find the value. Right, equals, I'm keeping A as is beta, sin A. Minus sin C, I can write C can be written as, right, C can be written as from this condition. 180 minus A, is it right, beta? Now observe this, it lies in the second quadrant. In second, sin is positive, 180 is even, so ratio will not be changed. So means we get sin A minus sin A, right, equals to 0. Similarly, consider RHS. What is RHS, beta? Sin D minus sin B. Here, I am keeping D as is. But D as is, I will change B beta. B can be written as, you can change anyone, either D or B. Not a problem beta. I am changing B with this condition. 180 minus D, here also we get same. Sin D minus sin D equals 0. Okay now beta? So that implies, therefore this one is over. So this is one. Next to second one, what is second beta? B. In this, consider beta. Cos A plus cos B plus cos C plus cos D. Okay, equals to, I'm keeping A and B as is beta, right? If I'm taking cos A as is, next I can write cos B. Cos B is also as is beta. Now I'm changing C. I can write C as 180 minus A. Is it right beta? Similarly, D can be written as 180 minus D. Okay, now with this, here cos A plus cos B is there. Next, if you observe 180 minus A, lies in second quadrant. In second, cos is negative. Is it right, beta? 180 is even, so the ratio will not be changed. So that is minus cos A. Here also minus, sorry, cos B. Minus cos B, right? So with this, all the terms are get cancelled, so zero. Therefore, the proof is over. Is it right, beta? Any doubts? No. Write down the solution, beta. Take diagram this one. Just to write the conditions, I am taking this graph diagram beta. From this diagram, it is easily observed. Alright, so write on, given. First write on beta, some procedure is there. Given A comma B comma C comma D are angles of a cyclic quadrilateral. Cyclic quadrilateral. In an exam that implies, take like this beta. Right? Right. That implies A plus C equals to 180 degrees, equation 1. And similarly, B plus D equals also 180 degrees, equation 2. Now, write all this. The procedure is same beta. If you have any doubts, send me a message, beta. I will explain once again. And B. So the procedure is same, beta. Here also we are using all silver teacups method, beta. Actually, the first exercise is right on the concept of all silver teacups, beta. Maximum. In this exercise, the problems are depending on all silver teacups method only. Now, I'll go to in fourth, first and second is completed, beta. Third one. Now we'll see in the fourth one, third one is completed or not. We'll check. After that, I will explain that problems, beta, in third with third one. Solve each and every problem, beta, in textbook. If you have any doubts, you will ask the questions, beta, I will explain. Right, completed, beta. Final, therefore. Here we are using all silver teacups concept, but we have to know these conditions, beta, whenever four angles are a cyclic, angles of a cyclic quadrilateral. So how you write this one, right, how you written this one means from this diagram only. Right. Now I'm asking one more question, beta. In second bit, in fourth, second bit, fourth question, in which the third one completed, beta. Third one. If the question is, I'm writing here, if tan square theta equals to 1 minus e square, comma, show that secant theta plus tan cube theta into cosecant theta equals to 2 minus e square all power 3/2. Anyone completed the beta this one? All of you completed this problem, beta? If not, write down that question. Write down the question. If tan square theta equals to 1 minus e square, comma, show that secant theta plus tan cube theta into cosecant theta equals to 2 minus e square all power 3/2. Whatever the questions I am asking, that are important problems, beta. That is why I am asking whether all of you completed or not. You may ask any problem, beta. If your answer is not getting, then you can ask. I will explain that problems. Whatever the problem it may be. Okay, na? Right. First lesson, beta. Completed. Writing question completed, beta. Right. First lesson. Here, given is, what is given, beta? Tan square theta equals to 1 minus e square. So this is the value of given. Okay. Now we have to prove the value of this one equals 2 minus e square all power 3/2. Is it right, beta? For this, first I am considering LHS, beta. That is secant theta plus tan cube theta into cosecant theta. Okay. Now my ambition is to use this value because this is the given. okay na beta, right? I want to use this tan square theta in this expression. Okay, so for this I'm writing tan cube theta as tan square theta into tan theta. Is it right, beta? I can write like this. Into here already there is cos cosecant theta is there. Okay na beta, clear? So with this tan theta into cosecant theta, what we are getting, beta? Right, secant theta plus tan square theta into, you can do the rough work, beta. Tan theta means sin theta by cos theta. No need to write fairly. You can take the rough work. Tan theta means I am writing here, beta. This is rough work. Okay, right. So I can write tan theta as sin by cos. Is it right, beta? Cosecant as 1 by sin. So sin sin it cancels. So remaining is 1 by cos. 1 by cos means I can write secant theta. Is it right, beta? No need to write it as fair. You can take the rough work. From rough work I am observing this is secant theta. Now in this, I can take secant theta as common. Is it right, beta? So if you take secant theta as common, then the remaining term is 1 plus tan square theta. Right, 1 plus tan square theta means by identity. What is the value, beta? What is the value of 1 plus tan square theta, anyone? What is the value of 1 plus tan square theta? Tell me, beta, what is the value of, right? Secant square theta by identity. Is it right, beta? From identity, I can write 1 plus tan square theta as secant square theta. Already there is secant theta. So finally, this is secant cube theta. Okay, na, beta? Now, I can write secant cube theta again, I can write secant theta is 1 plus tan square theta all power 1 by 2. Is it right, beta? I'm writing here secant theta as root over 1 plus tan square theta all power 3. Is it right, beta? Or I can write here only. I will write here, beta. So secant theta in terms of tan square theta, because I know the value of tan square theta. So now my ambition is to write secant theta in terms of tan square theta. How can you write, beta? By identity, I can write secant theta as root over 1 plus tan square theta. Is it right, beta? By using identity, I can write secant theta as root over 1 plus tan square theta into already there is 1 plus tan square theta. Right, if you observe, the bases are equal. Here the power of this one is 1 by 2. Root means 1 by 2. Here power is 1. So 1 by 2 plus 1 means 3 by 2. Is it right, beta? So finally we are getting 1 plus tan square theta all power 3 by 2. Now in this, substitute the value of tan square theta. What is the value of tan square theta, beta? 1 minus e square. If you add that, we get 2 minus e square all power 3 by 2. Is it right? Any doubts, beta? Once see the solution step by step. Once again I am explaining. Here given is this one. Now we want to find the value of this one, beta. For this, I am resolving tan cube theta into tan square theta into tan theta. Okay, na, beta? Right. So with this tan theta and cosecant theta, we get secant theta. You may take the rough work, beta. Right? Secant theta. In this, I can take secant theta as common. Now my ambition is to write this value in terms of tan square theta, because I know the value of tan square theta. That is why I want to convert this into terms of tan square theta like this. If you observe here, the bases are equal. Then we have to add the power. Here power is 1 by 2, here power is 1. So we get 3 by 2. Now substitute the value of tan square theta. Tan square theta means 1 minus e square. Already there is 1. With this we get 2 minus e square all power 3 by 2. Clear, beta? Right? So write down the solution. The procedure is same, beta. In IPE, we have to write some procedure, beta. For competitive, no need to write this step by step. You can write the direct answer. For IPE, we have to write some steps, beta. Then only we will get the full marks. After fire, therefore, write this one. If you have any doubts, send a message, beta. I will repeat once again. Now coming to third bit. Trigonometric identities are important, beta. We use identities. Here we are using secant theta value. We are writing the value of secant theta from identity. Application is most important. To get the answer, what is the formula? Here we are applying in trigonometry for only one term. We have number of formulas, beta. Right? In which, what is the formula? Here we have to applicable. Okay, application is most important. So for this, we have to remember all the formulas. Already I given the formulas, beta, before starting the problems. Last, write this one, beta. Therefore, secant theta plus tan cube theta into cosecant theta equal. Okay, completed, beta. Right. Now coming to third bit. In third bit, first question in first one, beta. So this is most important. Already we got this question in the previous examination in 4 marks, beta. Sometimes it will come in 2 marks. Right? First one is completed. I will write the question here. Third bit, first one first. Right? Prove that. They will ask the question like this, beta. Prove that tan theta plus secant theta minus 1 by tan theta minus secant theta plus 1 equals to 1 plus sine theta by cos theta. Completed, beta. Is there any doubts in this question? Okay, very good, Suprita. Still anyone? Completed, beta, this one? Prove that tan theta plus secant theta minus 1. Right, I will explain, beta. Very good, Amol. Still anyone? Suprata is saying that got the answer, sir. Okay, right. Very good, Amma. Remaining. Alright, I will explain. This is most important question in 4 marks, beta. Already we got in the previous examination. Right, all of you first listen here. Right, so here we have to prove the value of this one equals this. Right, for this, I am considering LHS, beta. Right, I am considering LHS. So I will write here solution. Given, first I am considering LHS value. Okay, this. So this equals to, now I am writing tan theta plus secant theta as t is beta. Now, remember one point. With this point we get the full marks, beta. I am writing 1 in terms of tan and secant. Okay, now beta, how can we write 1 in terms of secant and tan? We have one identity in secant and tan theta. Is it right, beta? I can write this one as secant square theta minus tan square theta. Is it right, beta? I can write this one as secant square theta minus tan square theta. Okay? In the denominator, I am not changing the one, beta. I am writing as this. Sir, why you are writing as this? I will explain later. I am changing only one in the numerator by using identity in terms of secant and tan by secant square theta minus tan square theta. Is it right, beta? Right? Now, in this, in the numerator, I can write tan theta plus secant theta minus of If you observe this now, this is in the form of a square minus b square. Is it right, beta? A square minus b square. I can write a square minus b square as a plus b into a minus b. Is it right, beta? A plus b into a minus b. Okay. So I am writing the denominator as this. What is the denominator here? Tan theta minus secant theta plus 1. Next, if you observe the numerator, in the numerator, what is the common factor, beta? Here tan theta plus secant theta is there. Here also tan theta plus secant theta is there. So I can take tan theta plus secant theta as common. Okay, beta? Right. If we take this term as common, then here the remaining is 1 minus. Here this one is taken as common. So the remaining is secant theta minus tan theta. I'm multiplying it with minus beta because there is minus. So with minus, now tell me minus into plus secant theta, minus secant theta, minus into minus tan theta, plus tan theta. Okay, beta, clear? So in the denominator, what is there? Right, tan theta minus secant theta plus 1. If you observe this term and this one, both are same. Is it right, beta? Here plus 1, here also plus 1. Minus secant theta, here also minus secant theta, plus tan theta, plus tan. Writing is different, but the same term. Is it right, beta? So this will get cancelled. That is why I am not changing the denominator. Okay, na? How do you know, sir? Because on the practice, it will be no beta. Right? So if you practice well, we know how to solve this problem. So in trigonometry, the procedure is important, beta. That means practice is most important. How can we find the answer? How can we find the required? So in this, these two will be get cancelled. Now, actually we have to prove that. In RHS, what we have? 1 plus sin theta by cos theta. That means we have to convert this into sin and cos. Now I can write tan theta. Tan theta can be written as sin theta by cos theta. Plus secant theta can be written as 1 by cos theta. Is it right, beta? Now take LCM as cos theta, then the remaining is 1 plus sin theta by cos theta. This is the RHS. Is it right, beta? Therefore, write an RHS. Okay, clear? Any doubts? Yeah, remember, beta. Here I am resolving 1. I am replacing 1 with the identity in terms of secant and tan. Okay, beta, I am replacing 1 in the numerator only, not in the denominator. I am writing 1 in the denominator as this. But I am converting, I am replacing 1 with identity in the numerator only. Any doubts, beta? One, see the solution step by step. If you have any doubts. Here we are using identity, beta, in terms of secant theta and tan theta. So then these two are get cancelled because these two are same. Writing is different. The order is different, but the contains same terms. We got this question in 4 marks, beta, important one. One, see the solution step by step. Amog, any doubts, beta? Rakshita, Navanit, and all the students, if you have any doubt, just send me one message, beta. I will repeat, I will explain once again. Same similar to this one, the second problem, beta, in this one. I think 1 plus cot theta minus cosecant theta into something. So in that we have to convert that into sin by cos. From that we get the answer. Sampath, second one is completed, beta, in this first bit. So that is in third bit, first one, second one. Right, very good. Third one is not completed, beta, Sampath. That is 3 into sin theta minus cos theta all power 4, that is. Now I want to explain the third problem, beta, Sampath. Right, I will explain beta. Completed this one. Right, neatly beta. You know, for IP processor is important. All right. In this second one is completed, beta. Once say this question. If not completed, I will explain. If completed, I will go to the next one. Prove that this is also important in 4 marks. 1 plus cot theta minus cosecant theta into 1 plus tan theta. Plus secant theta. 1 plus tan theta plus secant theta equals to 2. Here we have to write all the ratios in terms of sine and cos beta. Then we'll get the answer, right? Completed beta this problem. Can I explain? Once see this question, prove that there may be a chance to get this question in 4 marks beta. Sometimes we'll get in this question in 2 marks also. Computer, all of you, any doubts? Can I explain this one? Once see the question, beta. 1 plus cot theta minus cosecant theta into 1 plus tan theta plus secant theta equals 2. This is the second problem of first problem in third bit. Can I explain this one, beta? All right, I will explain once. See this solution, beta. Solution given. Yeah, I'm considering LHS beta. Right, this is given. Now, I want to show the value of this one is 2. Okay, for this, I'm writing 1 plus cot theta can be written as cos theta by sine theta. Okay, now, beta. Minus, yeah, cosecant theta. Right, cosecant theta can be written as 1 by sine theta. So, into, here also, 1 plus tan theta means sin theta by cos theta plus cos theta 1 by cos theta. With using identity also we can find beta, but this is easy method, that's why I'm taking, right? So with this what we are getting, if we take sin theta as LCM, here the LCM is cos theta, so the remaining is sin theta plus cos theta minus 1 into, here same cos theta plus sin theta plus 1 by, in the denominator I'm writing sin theta into cos theta. Is it right, beta? Now take this as one term. Okay, now, beta? Bar means it is treated as one term. Okay, now, beta? So now if you observe the numerator, this is in the form of a minus b into a plus b. Is it right, beta? A minus b into a plus b. What is the formula for a minus b into a plus b? A square minus b square, that is sin theta plus cos theta whole square minus 1. But already in the denominator there is sin theta into cos theta. Okay, now expand this whole square by using the formula a plus b whole square. From that we get sin square theta plus cos square theta plus 2 sin theta cos theta. Okay now beta, minus 1 by 2 sin theta cos theta. In this, sorry, sin theta cos theta. In this, sin square theta plus cos square theta means 1. Directly we can cancel beta, here minus 1. And sin theta cos theta, sin theta cos theta get cancelled. So finally the remaining is 2. Okay beta, got the answer? Simple. Right on. We'll get this question in 4 marks beta. Sometimes we get this question in 2 marks also. Alright. Now I will explain the third one. Simple problem beta. If you want to write one more step, you can write beta. 1 plus 2 sin theta cos theta minus 1 by this one. Finally, we get 2 only. Already we know the value for this one. Is it right beta? The value of this one is 1. So plus 1 minus 1 get cancelled. Again, sin theta cos theta get cancelled. So the remaining is 2. Now coming to our third one beta. right? So in this third one, prove that 3 into sin theta minus cos theta all power 4 plus 6 into, already we completed this type of problem in solver problems beta. One problem is completed in solver problems. Solver problems, problems also important beta. 4 into sin power 6 theta plus cos power 6 theta equals to 13. So this is the question. Okay, beta. First lesson, I can take one term individually, beta. First, I will find the value of this one. Again, this, or I can write all the terms at a time. Now, I'm considering all the times at a time, beta. Right. For this, listen, beta, carefully. This is an important one in 4 marks. Right. Given. Here, the given is this one. Equals, we have to prove the value is 13. For this, right, given, this equals to 3 into, I'm writing sin theta minus cos theta all power 4 as sin theta minus cos theta all square. Right, sin theta minus cos theta all square. Again, all square. Is it right, beta? Right, no change. Or you can write directly the value also, beta. Next, plus 6 into, I know the value of this one. I can expand this one, beta. Sin square theta plus cos square theta plus 2 sin theta cos theta. Is it right, beta? Next, in the next line, you may write in the next line, beta. Plus 4 into, now I am writing sin power 6 theta plus cos power 6 theta. Already we completed one problem in solved problem, beta. I can write this as sin square theta plus cos square theta all cube. Already I explained this in the previous class. Right, sin square theta plus cos square theta all cube. With this, in this, after expanding this one, already we know the formula of a plus b whole cube. Is it right, beta? A plus b whole cube formula is a cube. From a cube, we get this one. Plus b cube, we get this one. In this, there is one term extra. What is that? 3ab into a plus b. But we don't need that term. Because here we have only two terms. But whenever we are writing these two terms as like this, in this, there is one term extra that we have to subtract. What is the term, beta? Minus, so 3ab into a plus b, is it right now? So I want to subtract that one. So minus 3ab into a plus b. Is it right, beta? Understood this one? Already we completed this procedure in the previous class. Okay, now beta, clear? I can write this as, sir, why you are writing like this only? You may ask one doubt, beta. So, why are you are writing these terms as like this? Because I know the value of sin square theta plus cos square theta. Is it right, beta? That is why I am writing like this. Right? Next, after this, what we are getting here? So, 3 into. Now, this is, right, sin theta minus cos theta all square. Directly, we can write down, beta. Right, a square means sin square theta plus cos square theta. I am writing 1. Okay, now, beta, clear? 1 minus, here, what we are getting? 2 sin theta cos theta. For this, whole square is there. Right, 3 into. Okay, but understood this one. Why we are getting 1? Because a square plus b square means sin square theta plus cos square theta. We know the value. We can write directly, beta. No need to write sin square theta plus cos square theta. Directly, we can write the value. 1 minus 2 sin theta cos theta. Again, there is whole square. Okay, plus 6 into. In this, sin square theta plus cos square theta. 1. Here also, no need to write the 1, beta. Directly we can write the value. 1 plus, not a problem. 2 sin theta cos theta. Okay. Next, plus 4 into. Here also, beta. We can write the direct. Alright, 4 into. What we are getting? Yeah, this value is 1. Minus here also, this value is 1. So we get 3 sin square theta cos square theta. Is it right, beta? Okay. Now, again, expand this one. So 3 into, now tell me, this is in the form of a minus b whole square. So here a square means 1, plus b square. B square means we get 4 sine square theta into cos square theta. Is it right, beta? Again minus 2ab. Minus 2ab means minus 4 sine theta cos theta. Is it right, beta? So this is the expansion of this one. Now multiply with this. Plus 6 plus 6 into 2 means 12 sine theta cos theta. Again we have here plus 4 minus 12 sine square theta cos square theta. So if we observe all the terms in this, 3 into 4 means 12, here minus 12, this will get cancelled. Okay, next 3 into minus 4 means minus 12. See here beta, 3 into minus 4 means minus 12 sine theta cos theta plus 12 sine theta cos theta get cancelled. So now the remaining terms are 3 into 1, 3 plus 6 plus 4. From this finally we are getting 13. This is the answer. Okay, beta, understood? Any doubt? Once see the solution step by step. Once again I will explain beta. Actually, all power 4. I don't know the formula for A minus B all power 4. Is it right, beta? For this, I am resolving 4 into A minus B whole square, whole square. Is it right, beta? I am writing like that only. Here, already we know the formula of A plus B whole square, I have written. Next, for this, I am taking sine square theta plus cos square theta whole cube. Okay, after expanding this, what are the terms we are here getting? From A cube, we get this term. From B cube, we get this one. In this expansion, we have one more term. What is that? 3 plus 3ab into a plus b. Is it right, beta? But I don't want that term. That means we have to subtract. That is minus 3ab. Here a is sine square theta, b is cos square theta into a plus b. Okay, now I am expanding this one. This is, if you observe this, a minus b whole square form. A square plus b square means we get 1. Minus 2ab means minus 2 sine theta cos theta, there is another square. Okay, next I am writing the substituting sine square theta plus cos square theta as 1. Okay, now beta, clear? Next I am again expanding this one because here we have whole square. Right, from the formula A minus B whole square we are getting this value. If you observe all the terms here, plus 12 sine square theta cos square theta minus 12 get cancelled. Plus 12 sine theta cos theta minus 12 sine theta cos theta get cancelled. So the remaining is 13. Okay beta, clear? Write down the solution. You may take single terms beta. You may consider one term and find the value. Take that equation 1, equation 2, equation 3. Again take a LHS. You may write the solution like that also. But I am writing here all the terms at a time. I am taking all the terms beta. Sampath, okay beta, understood? Right. In the third bit, second, any doubts beta completed? I think time is completed. So tomorrow we'll discuss the problem. Once see the questions in third bit, second. In second we have totally 4 problems beta. 1, 2, 3, 4. I think already given these problems as homework yesterday. All these are completed beta. Still any doubts in that problems? 1 2 3 4 in that four problems there are some okay third problem very good I will explain beta second one is completed second is most important beta in that second problem in the second of third bit second is important okay so I will explain in the next class beta because today time is over right so today I am not giving any homework just see all the problems of exercise 6a and before exercise 6a we have solved problems beta in that also once look the each and every problem whether we are completed or not right so whatever the problems we are not covered in the class we'll discuss in the next class because I think in the next class we have 3 or 4 problems beta right with that the 6a first exercise will be completed in this topic okay so that just see each and every problem in your textbook in exercise and also the problems before exercise we have some solved problems beta so the board will ask 50% of choices there beta they will give the questions from solved problems and 50% questions from exercise that is why I explained solved problems especially is it right I explain I think all the problems in the solved problems I explained in the previous classes because there is a 50% of chance to get that questions in the annual examination okay na beta so once see the exercise problems and the solved problem if we are not getting the answer of any one question any question then you may ask in the next class okay na beta so tomorrow we'll complete the first exercise of this topic of trigonometric ratios up to transformation okay clear right once see all the problems whether we are completed or not just to see if you are not completed then you can ask in the next class okay beta thank you one and all and bye beta